अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ मोहम्मद इब्राहिम। वेलकम टू मिशाल एजुकेशन। डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फिज़िक्स ओ लेवल कैम्ब्रिज इंटरनेशनल एग्जामिनेशन, ओ लेवल्स, ए लेवल्स, आईजी, सीएससी एंड एडिक्सल सिलेबस 2020-2022। द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ दिस सिलेबस इज मेजरमेंट और मेजरमेंट ऑफ फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज। Physical quantities, all those quantities which can be measured are called physical quantities. There are two types of physical quantities, that is base quantity or basic quantities. Sometimes it is called fundamental quantities. A base quantity or basic quantity is chosen and arbitrarily defined rather than being derived from combination of other physical quantities. In other words, we can say that physical quantities are all those quantities which can independently exist and not derived from any other quantities. There are 7 base quantities mentioned in the table, the physical quantities and their base SI units: mass, kilogram, length, meter, time, second, current, I, ampere, temperature, unit is Kelvin, amount of substance, units is mole, and luminous of intensity or intensity of light, candela. SI units are used as standard units in all the measurement in the world. SI unit is a short form for international system of units. The second type is derived quantities. A derived quantity is defined based on the combination of base quantities and has derived unit, that is exponent, product or quotient of the base quantities. In other words, we can say that derived quantities are those quantities which are derived or obtained from base quantity. For example, the combination of two or more than two base quantities form another quantity, that is called derived quantities. The units such as joule, newton, volt, ohm are SI units, but they are not base SI unit. Dimension analysis. The main idea of deriving a derived unit is to treat unit like algebraic terms, manipulate them according to get the right derived unit for the quantity. Two example is given at the bottom of the next page that will go for walkthrough. Few examples of derived quantities are mentioned in this table, that force unit is newton, n, and its base units are kilogram, meter per second square. Energy, joules, J, kilogram, meter square per second square. Power is watt, W, kilogram, meter square per second cube. Frequency, hertz, Hz, second inverse. Charge, coulomb, C, ampere second. Voltage, volt, V, symbol hai, kilogram, meter square per second inverse, per second cube, per ampere inverse. Resistance, ohm, omega, kilogram square per second cube, per ampere square. Practice of two examples for derived quantities. An example of derived quantities energy, which has derived unit of joules, which is kilogram meter square per second square, or kilogram meter square upon second square is the base SI units. Example 2, another example of derived quantity is density, that is density is equal to mass upon volume, has derived quantity mass kilogram upon volume meter cube, or kilogram meter cube is the SI units. After that, we are going to study prefixes. Prefixes are useful for expressing unit of physical quantities that are either very big or very small. If you write out such big or small number, it will be time consuming and prone to errors. Some of the Greek prefixes and their symbols to indicate decimals of multiples and multiples of the SI unit are given in the table. That is 10 power minus 9 is equal to nano, 10 power minus 6 is equal to micro, 10 power minus 3 is equal to milli, 10 power 9 there. It can be written as 1 multiplied by 10 power 9 bytes or 0.000052. This is the place of reference point will be put here. The point and place of reference there are 6 numbers that is equal to 10 power 6. 5.2 microcoulomb with prefix, and if we remove the prefix then it will be equal to 5.2 multiplied by 10 power minus 6 seconds. Now we are going to study about vector quantities and scalar quantities. Scalar quantities are the quantities in which magnitude is stated but the direction is either not applicable or not specified. Means these are the physical quantities which have magnitude and unit but have no direction. For example, length, volume, mass and speed are the examples of scalar quantity. They have magnitude, numerical value, unit, but they do not have any direction. Vector quantities are the quantities in which both magnitude and direction must be stated. In other words, we can state those physical quantities which can be specified by either magnitude, numerical values is called magnitude, suitable units and direction also. For example, force, velocity, displacement and acceleration are the types of other scale vector quantities. Now we are going to measure the length, measurement of length. Length is the distance between two points. The SI unit of length is meter. It is a scalar quantity. The apparatus which is used, instrument which is used to measure the length, first of all is meter tape. Meter tape is used to measure the length of any substance which have which are bendable or which have curved shape. Equipment, it is made up of long flexible tape, can be measured up to measure the object or place up to 10 to 50 meters in length. Usually they are used in building construction and tailors. It has making similar to that of rigid rule. The smallest marking could be 0.1 centimeter or could be larger than 0.5 centimeter or more than or even 1 centimeter. How to use the zero mark of the measuring tape is first align flat to the end of the object. The tape is stretched toward to the other end. The reading is taken where the other end of the object meets the tape. Accuracy of meter tape is 0.1 to 1 centimeter. After that, the next instrument is meter rule or meter ruler. Equipment, it is made up of long rigid piece of wood or steel. It can be measured the object up to 100 centimeter in length. The smallest marking is usually 0.1 centimeter or 1 millimeter. How to use the zero end of the ruler is first lying flat with the one end of the object, and the reading is taken where the other end of the object is meet to the rule. Accuracy of meter rule is 0.1 centimeter or 1 millimeter. That is the minimum reading mentioned on that. To measure the smallest distance or the length of a small object, we can use vernier clipper. A vernier clipper consists of upper jaws, lower jaws, a vernier scale, that is sliding scale, screw comb for tightening the object, our main scale and the stem for the measuring the depth. Uses of the these all parts we will discuss in the next paragraph. Equipment, it is made up of main scale and vernier scale and can usually measure up to 15 centimeter length. The smallest marking is usually 0.1 centimeter on the main scale and 0.01 centimeter on the vernier scale. The pair of external jaws, about this external jaws is measured the external diameter, and the pair of internal jaws measure the internal diameter, internal jaws. Long rigid long rod is measured the depth. This is called stem. How to use the jaws is first close to find the zero error. The jaws then operate the object firmly and the reading is taken. Accuracy of the vernier clipper is plus minus 0.01 centimeter or 10th part of 1 millimeter. After that we are going to study the micrometer screw gauge. A micrometer screw gauge consists of anvil, spindle, sleeve or the main scale. Here is the line. This line is called Dedham line, and circular scale that is called thimble scale, and ratchet to tightening the object without any external force, pressure, and this is firm. Equipment, it is made up of main scale and thimble scale and can be measured object up to 5 cm in length. The smallest marking is usually 1 mm on the main scale or sleeve and 0.1 mm on the thimble scale or thimble. The thimble has total of 50 marking, represents 0.5 millimeter. If two round trip, its two round trips is equal to 1 millimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 millimeter. It has an anvil and spindle to hold the object, anvil and spindle, and ratchet to the thimble to accurate tightening, preventing our wetting. This is ratchet. How to use the spindle is first closed on the anvil to find the zero error. Use the ratchet for careful tightening. The spindle is then open to fit the object firmly. Use the ratchet to careful tightening, and the reading is taken. Accuracy is plus minus 0.01 millimeter. The choose of measuring equipment depend on the degree of accuracy required. Range of length, equipment, accuracy and examples. Length less than 100 cm, measuring tape will use. Accuracy of measuring tape is plus minus 0.1 cm circumference of your wrist. You can example can measure with the meter tube. 5 centimeters length is greater than 5 centimeter and less than 100 meter. Meter rule can be used. Plus minus 0.1 centimeters its accuracy. The length of your phone you can measure with the help of meter rule. Length is greater than 1 centimeter and less than 100 centimeter. Vernier clipper is used. Accuracy of vernier clipper is 0.01 centimeter. The diameter of beaker you can find with the help of vernier clipper. Length is greater than 2 cm. Micrometer screw gauge is used. Its accuracy is plus minus 0.01 cm or plus minus 0.101 mm. Thickness of a piece of wire can be measured with the help of micrometer. Measuring time. SI unit of time is second. It is scalar quantity. The standard of the unit of the time is the exact duration. We can say that 1 second is basically equal to the cesium 133 atom completes this amount of vibration in the time duration is called second. Below some types of clocks or watches used to find out the time. Atomic clock is used to measure the short interval of time about 0.1 to 10 seconds. Digital stopwatch used to measure the short interval of time minute, second, and an accuracy plus minus 0.1 second. Analog stopwatch is used to measure short interval of time minute and second to accuracy of 0.1 second. Ticker tape timer used to measure short time interval of 0.02 second. Watch used to measure long time interval, hours, minute and seconds. Pendulum used to measure the long time interval, hours, minutes and second. Radioactive decay clock is used to measure long time interval, of year 2000 years. Now the device or instruments which are used to measure the time is clock, stopwatch. Equipment, it can be read in hour, minutes and second. How to use it? The clock is set to commence at the particular time, or the time start time is noted. The time even is then allowed to occur, and at the end of the event the end time is noted. The difference provide the required time interval. Accuracy of clock is 1 second plus minus. Stopwatch, it reads up to 0.01 second. How to use it? As the time even occurs, at the time even occurs, the stopwatch start at the same time. At the end of the event, the stopwatch is stopped and the end time is noted. The reading provides the required time interval. Some precise stopwatch are connected electronically to the time event and hence more accurate result. Accuracy is 0.1 seconds. After that, ticker tape timer. A ticker tape timer is a machine that produces dot on the tape at fixed time interval. How to use? The tape is attached to the end to an object, and the state of the object state of motion of object can be deduced from the dot on the tape. Reading the tape from ticker tape timer, there are three ticker tape readings. The procedure to reading deduce the state of motion from the resulting tape is best explained using an example. The figure above consists of three tapes X, Y and Z with the length of 1 meter of first dot to the last dot. The dots are made by ticker tape timer with the time interval of 0.1 second. For X, the dots are evenly spaced, hence the length of length is 1 meter. The space between the each dot is 0.2 meter. When we can calculate the speed of the object using speed is equal to distance upon time is equal to 0.2 distance upon 0.1 seconds is equal to 2 meter per second. Hence X represents the tape from an object that moving at constant speed. For Y, the spacing between the dot increase as time pass. Since the dots are made with the fixed time interval, the time in the formula above is fixed. We get the increasing speed as the distance between the dot increase. Hence Y represents the tape of an object in accelerating. For Z, the spacing between the dot decreasing as time passes. Using the same reasoning as above, Z represents the tape from an object that is decelerating. After that, we are going to study error and its type. An error is defined as the difference between measured and actual value is called error. These errors are categorized by personal error, systemic error, and random error. Personal error. Personal error arises due to tendency or carelessness of the person in taking the reading. Systematic error. This type of error arises due to fault in measuring instrument. And random error. This type of error arises due to external condition, which may be sometime beyond the control of experiment area. After that, accuracy and precision. Accuracy is measure how close the result of an experiment agree with the true value. When high is the accuracy, there is small systemic error. The accuracy of reading can be improved by repeating the experiment. Precision is measure the how close the result of an experiment agree with the each other. For multiple experiment, it is defined. It is a measure how reproducible the results are high precision implies a small uncertainty and small random error. Precision is how close measured value are to each other, but they may not be necessarily clustered about the true value. Zero error and parallax error affect the precision of an instrument. Parallax error: for accurate measurement, the eye must be always placed vertical above the mark being read, as given here. This is to avoid the parallax error, which will give rise to inaccurate measurement. In this condition, parallax error occurs, but you have to read in this manner. Zero error of vernier caliper: when the jaws are closed, the vernier zero mark coincides with them a zero mark on its fixed scale or main scale. Before taking any reading, it is good to practice to close the jaws or face of instrument to make sure the reading is zero. If it is not, then note the reading. This reading is called zero error. The zero error is of two types: positive zero error and negative zero error. What is positive zero error? Here we can say that we can see that the zero of vernier scale not coinciding with zero of vernier scale, it means there is some zero error. Positive zero error: if the zero on the vernier scale is not right, is to the right of the main scale, then the error arises to be positive zero error, and so the zero correction should be subtracted from the reading which is measured. Negative zero error: zero of vernier scale is left to the main scale. If the zero on the vernier scale is left to the main scale, then the error is said to be negative zero error, and so the zero correction should be added to the reading which is measured. Now, zero errors in micrometer screw gauge: if the datum line coincides with the zero of thimble, then there is no zero error. If the zero of the thimble scale is below the datum line, there is positive zero error. If the zero of thimble is above the datum line, then there is some negative zero error. As we know that zero error, positive zero error should be subtracted from the measurement, and negative error should be added to the measurement. Now we can read positive zero error: if the zero marking on the thimble is below the datum line, the micrometer has positive zero error. Whatever reading is taken on the micrometer, we would have to subtract the zero correction for the reading. As negative zero error: if the zero marking on the thimble is below the datum line, the micrometer has negative zero error. Whatever the reading we take on the micrometer, we would have to add zero correction from the reading. And that's the end of this chapter. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Also like and comment on our video. It will be pleasure for us. Thank you.